I'm going to start going over a little bit about vectors. And vectors are some of the most important things, especially for Physics 121, because they're pretty much all that you're going to be using in Physics 121. Now, a vector, I don't know if you guys have ever seen the movie Despicable Me. There's a character and he calls himself Vector because he has both magnitude and direction. And it's supposed to be a joke, but that's actually the official definition of a vector, is that they have both a magnitude and a director
and a direction.
And that's kind of funny. I never thought about that.
Yeah. And so the other way you can think of vectors is just like, they're just arrows basically. And, but they're super convenient because we can kind of add them together and use them to represent kind of like the direction of force, or if you're doing electrical engineering, go later on, you can use it for like electric fields or magnetic fields or any of that sort of stuff. But for now, just for the basics, I just kind of want to go over the two ways that you can add vectors together. And so the first method is called the head to tail or triangle. And basically you just take the tail of one vector and you just put it right at the head, which is like the arrow, and you just follow it to the new point. So it's kind of like you're just connecting them together. And then the other method, which I don't really prefer because it's a little bit more complicated, is called the parallelogram method, which is basically you just take the two vectors and you make a parallelogram out of them. And then you draw from the two corners of those that parallelogram. But that method's kind of, I don't know, I feel like it takes more steps. I feel like the head-to-tail method is a lot easier to understand.
I have a quick question about the parallelogram method.
Okay.
So you have the, like, you have the long diagonal on that, which is U plus B. And then you have, like, the short diagonal, right? Which is like, I don't know, can I annotate on the screen?
I think I have to give you permission. Just wait one second. Oh, yes you can.
Okay, so like, what's that then?
Oh, the line you just drew?
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to think. I don't think it's really anything.
All right.
Sorry.
It's all good. I was just wondering.
Okay. Yeah, so if you're doing vector subtraction, you kind of do the, it's kind of like being the same as adding a negative. So let's say you're doing U minus V. So instead of what you would do is you would take V and you would flip it around, right? It would be like negating it. And then you would do the head-to-tail method again, just adding them together. But since one's negative, it's the same thing as like subtraction. In fact, I might just show you real quick. When I stop screen sharing, you guys can see the paper a lot better, right?
Yes.
Okay, sorry. So like, for example, you have U and you have V. Actually, let me do a different V. Let me do one that's like this. V. All right. And you want to do U minus V. And we usually draw these little arrows, and that means vector. Right? So I can take U as it is, but V, since it's a negative, what I would do is I would flip it around. So that would be like this. So that's like a negative V, right? And then I would use that and I would add it on to this using the head to tail method, right? And then what I would do is you take the origin of the first vector and the head of the other one, you draw a new vector, and that's the vector you're looking for. That would be U minus V. I hope that wasn't too confusing.
So could you just technically just do u minus v in the first place? You're just physically demonstrating on how to do it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah. So, and this is pretty helpful. So, like, for example, let's say you have, like, a box in space, right? So there's no air, there's no gravity, and it's just floating in space. And then you put a force on that box going this direction, right? And let's say it's 3 newtons, right? Well, someone else comes along, and they put another force on that box, let's say 5 newtons. But this force is in the downward direction. But you still have the 3 newton force that's pushing it, let's say, right. So what will happen is the total force vector is you would add these two together, right? So you have this new box. I should actually be drawing it in the middle. And it's going to be like 3 over and 5 down. So this would be your actual force vector. Or we would call it net force vector. Or your magnitude. So this is a convenient way of, you know, understanding the direction of forces and how other things work.